Good morning, students. So today's topic, as it is reflecting on your screens, is Outcomes of Democracy from Political Science Textbook. Fine. So today we are going to learn about assessing democracy's outcomes. Outcomes means results. Okay. The effects of democracy we are going to study today. Okay. So basically, this is to conclude whatever we have learned in the prior standards, 9th standard, we have learned why democracy and what is democracy, okay, if you remember the lesson, right? So let's start. We have studied about the features of democracy and also studied why it is one of the best form of government. In this chapter, let us study its outcomes, means the results or effects of democracy, as I said previously. Now, why is democracy considered better? Following other reasons. So, equality among citizens then enhances the dignity of individual, improves quality of decision making, resolves conflict, allows rooms to correct mistakes. So, if you see the points what are mentioned there, they are the conclusion of what we have read till date. Agree to this? Equality among citizens. What does that mean? That each individual has the right to vote. Whether he is poor, whether he is rich, whether he is working, whether he is having a business, irrespective to any aspect of life, equality is maintained. That is, everyone has an equal right to vote. Now, enhancing, yes, the condition is that the person should be above 18 years. And in respect to the gender also, right? So now, second point is that enhancing dignity of individual. What does that mean? That means everyone is given respect. Suppose there is a court case going on or some conflict is there. So everyone is heard, right? It is not that anyone is just because he is a smaller person or a poorer person or gender differentiation is there that he is not given importance, right? So, value to every individual has been given. That is, dignity is given, respect is given, okay? Improves quality of decision making. Now, as we have studied for the government also, and even in the smaller case, at state level, at individual level also, decision making is, we have a quality decision making. That means the positive as well as negative aspects of any particular thing, event is taken into consideration while making a decision. Okay. Then resolves conflicts. Now here, with all this above what I have said, it becomes very easy, or we have a better method can be implemented, to use and resolve the conflict. And all this then ultimately allows room to correct mistakes. So whatever the mistake is, who is guilty, that person can accept it easily and he can move on further. Okay. It's not stagnant. Not only they don't have to just hear what is wrong. We give a place or a room to rectify the mistakes. Did you get all this? Let's go to the next slide. Now, assess democracy's outcomes. Now, do you think a democracy supports all these expectations? Expectations, so what are the expectations in the democracy? Or whatever we have read about that, does it follow procedure and is transparent to people? Then the responses to need and expectations, efficient decision making and implementation. Is this all facilitated? Are the expectations supported? In practice, not all of these are realized, although democracies as a general rule functions on the same principles. They differ in terms of their social, economic and ethnic environment. So we do agree that though we are saying that some expectations are there from democracy, but in real life we see that all of them are not satisfied at a same time. Okay, so why this happens? Because there is a difference between their social, economic and ethnic environment. Now the first step towards realizing the outcome of democracy is to understand that it is after all just a form of government. It's a form of government. It is not monarchy, it is not a king who will be heard, or it is not a dictatorship that person will take a decision, right? Decision making in democracy takes time, and that is why something will get solved earlier and later on the other things. Okay, priorities differs, what I want to say is. Okay, so it is just a form of government. It is not the ultimate person or a group who will immediately give you decisions. So now let us see democracy as accountable, responsive and legitimate government. In a democracy, the citizens are involved in decision making, which includes choosing their rulers too. This is the basic thing, right? So the first outcome of democracy should definitely be a government that is accountable, answerable. Accountable means the government is answerable to its citizens and take into consideration their needs and expectations, right? So at this juncture, think, is democracy an efficient form of government? This is up to you. Now you have to answer this personal response. In a non-democratic government, the leaders don't have to worry about these needs. So non-democratic government, it can be anything. It can be monarchy, it can be military, okay, or it can be dictatorship. So in a non-democratic government, the leaders don't have to worry about these needs, the needs of the citizens. So decisions are quick. So their decisions are very quick, because they don't consider each and every individual or the citizen or a group of people, right? But the citizens aren't going to be too pleased with taking a quick decision. All the citizens are not pleased, okay? So conflicts are bound to happen. Even though the decision is given, there are some conflicts which are bound to take place. In this scenario, although the turnaround time for a decision is less as compared to that of a democratic government, was the decision effective in its implementation? So you have already answered it, okay? Because it will not favor all, right? On the other hand, a democratic government works on negotiations and deliberations. What does that translate into? What will happen if the government is working on negotiation and deliberations? Delays in decisions. Delays are there, but the person is satisfied, or the community or the citizens are satisfied, okay? But you know why delay occurred in the first place? To avoid conflicts and ensure everyone's interests are considered. So the amount of time will buy more than a non-democratic government is actually far more effectively applied for here. Now let us consider how a decision is made. A democratic government is transparent in its functioning. That is, a citizen, any citizen, irrespective to anyone, any citizen can ask to know if the correct procedures were followed, as opposed to the non-democratic government. A democracy needs to work in a legitimate manner and at all times remains answerable to its citizens. Okay, so non-democratic government, they don't have to answer anyone. Here, the democratic government, to any citizen, if he asks whether the procedure was followed, a correct procedure was followed. You can verify this transparency through policies, elections, etc. Okay, so you have access to it. Yes, right to know. Unfortunately, a democracy is not free from corruption despite the transparency and legitimacy it boosts off. Okay, so what you can say, failure तो नहीं बोल सकते but lagging बोल सकते हैं, ठीक है? So democracy is not free of corruption despite the transparency. However, at the end of the day, a democratic government represents its people. Thus, there is support towards the concept of democracy from all over the world. So, if we consider the merits and demerits, all over the world, democracy is voted. Everyone likes to have a democratic government. Okay? The citizens prefer this form of government, and so support is also an outcome that should be considered. So that was all for today's PPT. Okay. The next slide says that you have to read from the beginning of the lesson, that is page number 90, till the end of the page 92. Okay? Yes. How do we assess democracy's outcomes? Okay, that is the name of the chapter. So, do you remember how students in Madame Lido's class argued about democracy? This was in chapter 2 of class 9 textbook. It emerged from that conversation that democracy is a better form of government when compared with dictatorship or any other alternative. We felt that democracy was better because it promotes equality among citizens, enhances the dignity of individual, improves the quality of decision making, provides a method to resolve conflicts, and allows room to correct mistakes. Are these expectations realized under democracy? When we talk to people around us, most of them support democracy against other alternatives. Such a rule by a monarch or military or religious leaders, but not dissatisfied with the democracy in practice. So we face a dilemma, confusion. When democracy is seen to be good in principle, not so good in its practice. This dilemma invites us to think hard about the outcomes of democracy. Do we prefer democracy only for moral reasons, or are these some prudential reasons to support democracy too? Over 100 countries of the world today claim and practice some kind of democratic politics. They have formal constitutions, they hold elections, they have parties. While these features are common to most of them, these democracies are very much different from each other in terms of their social situation, their economic achievements, and their cultures. Clearly, what may be achieved or not achieved under each of these democracies will be very difficult. Will be very different. But is there something that we can expect from every democracy just because it is a democracy? Our interest is and fascination for democracy often pushes us into taking a position that democracy can address all socio-economic and political problems. If some of our expectations are not met, we start blaming the idea of democracy. Now, the picture whatever you are seeing at your left hand side of the screen, okay? So a person is sitting there and another common man, right? The cartoon common man, which is shown as democracy there, okay? So the person represents democracy, okay? And there are stones coming to it. So what are these stones? Read out whatever is written on the stones. Actually, the stones of different aspects of the democracy. It's cool. He's just listening to whatever the demand to him and advising him to take decisions on this. Yes, to get a separate state, to get more DA, then the students' demands are there. So many such issues are coming to the democracy. So these are all problems. Okay, read on page number 90. part of it is still remaining. So we have read that democracy can address all socio-economic and political problems. If some of our expectations are not met, we start blaming the idea of democracy, right? Or we start doubting if we are living in a democracy. The first step towards thinking carefully about the outcomes of democracy is to recognize that democracy is just a form of government. As the PPT said, that it is just a form of government. Decisions will be delayed. Okay, it is not a person who is going to give you immediate response or immediate, right? It can only create conditions for achieving something. The citizens have to take advantages of those conditions and achieve their goals. Let us examine some of the things we can reasonably expect from democracy and examine the record of democracy. Now let's go to the next page, that is accountable, responsive and legitimate government. There are some things that democracy must provide. In a democracy, we are most concerned with ensuring that people will have the right to choose their rulers, and people will have control over the rulers. Whenever possible and necessary, citizens should be able to participate in decision making that affects them all. Therefore, the most basic outcome of democracy should be that it produces a government that is accountable to the citizens and responsive to the needs and expectations of the citizens. Before we go into this question, we face another common question. Is the democratic government efficient? Is it effective? Some people think that democracy produces less effective government. It is, of course, true that non-government rulers do not have to bother about deliberations in assemblies or worry about majorities and public opinion. So they can be very quick and efficient in decision making and implementation. Democracy is based on the idea of deliberation and negotiation. So some delay is bound to take place. Does that make democratic government inefficient? Of course not. Now let us think in terms of cost. Imagine a government that may take decisions very fast, but it may take decisions that are not accepted by the people and may therefore face problem. In contrast, the democratic government will take more time to follow procedures before arriving at a decision. But because it has followed procedures, its decisions may be both more acceptable to the people and more effective. So the cost of time that democracy pays is perhaps worth it. So the cartoon on the space right hand side, what your screen is showing. So what is it? What is known about you? Okay, and after the filters, like each part of that telescope, we can say that it tells you the filters. It takes you the steps taken to make decisions, and then you come to know what you know about it. So that is the people. Government knows that what is known about you, and the public then knows what exactly is the matter. Okay. So in this way, as told earlier also, such type of cartoons can also be asked for the exam to explain also, okay, while you are reading. When you are following the directive. Now look at the other side. Democracy ensures that decision making will be based on norms and procedures. So a citizen who wants to know if a decision was taken through the correct procedure can find this out. She has the right and the means to examine the process of decision making. This is known as transparency. This factor is often missing from the non-democratic government. Therefore, when we are trying to find out the outcomes of democracy, it is a right to expect democracy to proceed to produce a government that follows procedures and it is accountable. We can also expect that democratic government develops mechanisms for citizens to hold the government accountable and mechanisms for citizens to take part in decision making whenever they think fit. If you wanted to measure democracies on the basis of this expected outcomes, you should look for the following practices and institutions: regular, free and fair election, open public debate on major policies and legislations, and citizens' right to information about the government and its functioning. The actual performance of democracies show a mixed record on this. Democracies have had greater success in setting up regular and free elections and in setting up conditions for open public debate. But most democracies fall short of elections that provide a fair chance to everyone and in subjecting every decision to public debate. Democratic governments do not have a very good record when it comes to sharing information with citizens. All one can say in favor of democratic regimes is that they are much better than any non-democratic regime in these respects. In substantive terms, it may be reasonable to expect from democracy government that is attentive to the needs and demands of the people and is largely free of corruption. The record of democracies is not impressive on these two counts. Democracies often frustrate the needs of the people and often ignore the demand of the majority of its population. The routine tells of corruption are enough. The routine tells of corruption are enough to convince us that democracy is not free of all this evil. At the same time, there is nothing to show that non-democracies are less corrupt or more sensitive to the people. So if we debate even the non-democratic governments or democracies are also corrupted and are not that sensitive to the people. There is one respect in which democratic government is certainly better than its alternatives. Democratic government is legitimate government. Legitimate means responsible. और acceptable. तो जो भी आप बोलते हो वो सुनता है democratic government. ओके, दैट मीन्स लेजिटिमेट. यस, बेस्ट है. बेस्ट नहीं बोल सकते हैं आप, रिस्पॉन्सिबल बोल सकते हैं पूरा. ओके, इट मे बी स्लो, लेस इफेक्टिव, नॉट ऑलवेज वेरी रिस्पॉन्सिव और क्लीन, बट अ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट इज पीपल्स ओन गवर्नमेंट. दैट इज वाई देर इज एन ओवरविलिंग सपोर्ट फॉर democracy all over the world. As the accompanying evidence from South Asia shows, the support exists in countries with democratic regimes as well as countries without democratic regimes. People wish to be ruled by representatives elected by them. They also believe that democracy is suitable for their country. Democracy's ability to generate its own support is itself an outcome that cannot be ignored. Okay, so you need to observe the figure given down. Okay, so democracy is preferred over dictatorship wherever except Pakistan. Pakistan, as you know, they have the government, but the military is more superior, is more decision making rather than the government. Okay, so the chart shows you that Bangladesh, India, Nepal, Pakistan and Sri Lanka. So what they prefer? Yes, the military is more powerful. So democracy is preferable by nearly all the five countries. Dictatorship is better. Very less people say that. Doesn't matter to me, like whether it is dictatorship or democracy. So that is the what you can see, the count, how people react to the question, that preference of the different types of government.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.